Hello everybody. For my 30th knife review movie already. God, that went quickly. Well, I thought to do something a bit different. Something a bit special. It is true that most of my knife reviews tend to be, let's say, more the gentleman kind of knives, the lifestyle kind of knives, which I do think do not get enough attention on YouTube. That's why I started doing them. Now, here I do something which is quite out of the ordinary. We will have a look really to centuries and even thousands of years ago. We will examine the prehistoric kind of knives and then something from the Saxon area, roughly between the 4th and the 10th century. First, this one. This is actually a replica of a native Indian kind of blade. But actually, this is very similar to prehistoric people in general. This one uses a blade made from obsidian. Obsidian is kind of a volcanic glass. If after a volcanic explosion, the magma cools very quickly, then often it cools into a kind of a glass-like structure. You can see it's a bit translucent. very similarly to this, what actually some of these old tools are made from silex, flintstone. Actually, like indeed the cartoon, flint is actually also kind of a crystal that exists in nature. Well, you can imagine that at one point, one of our ancestors must have found out that indeed that these rocks, glass rocks, you could say, have very sharp edges and they can be spliced into very sharp shards. And so that is how in ancient times, I'm talking about thousands of years ago, the technique of napping, that's actually written with a K, was created to actually, with a harder piece of stone, split a piece of, in this case, obsidian, until you've got a blade-like form. Now, obviously, if you would try this now yourself at home, with a piece of obsidian, you would notice that you need years of practice and a lot of bandages because you will cut yourself. So it's not evident at all to do this. So, and that's why I think, well, if you are into knives, this is, I don't use it. You could use it to cut meat, eh? It is pretty sharp. It's also a bit brittle, but for me this is purely a display thing and I think it's very beautiful. So it uses a stag horn handle, which is bound together with some glue towards the obsidian blade. I think it's very beautiful. And really, this gives a picture of our ancestors. Your grandfather from 20,000 years ago probably used this to cut, to prepare his mammoth stew. It's lovely. It's also beautiful, like all these classic designs actually, I think in their simplicity tend to be beautiful. So it's worth adding to your collection, I think, and put on display this or something made from flint, which tends to be similar in form. The other one, this is called a Scramasax. So it's a kind of a Roman/Saxon kind of knife from, like I said, between roughly the 4th to the 10th century. It's really late Roman era and the dark Middle Ages. This is a reproduction by Hanwei, which is a Chinese company which is very popular for all kind of historical reproductions of swords and katanas and the like. By the way, this one, I forgot actually, I ordered it online, but for the life of it I cannot remember where, but if you look for Google for obsidian knife, you will find it. I forgot to say one thing. These obsidian knives, it's still being used for chirurgical scalpels because it's so hard and can be cut very sharply. So it's not yet completely out of date. I go back to this one. So, kind of knife. This is a compact one. Which you wear horizontally. You see the belt piece here is for a horizontal carry, or in fact kind of a concealed carry in the day for various small cutting tasks or if really it was needed for self-defense. I take it out. Isn't it beautiful? It looks like a precision scalpel for craft work. This one is actually uses a piece of bone as a handle. So yes, bone was often used, or it could have been wood. And a carbon steel handle, that is, if you see this, it is engraved with a typical pattern that is found on these old 1500 year old knives. It is, so this is a beautiful reproduction because it's sharp and you could use it for various precise cutting tasks. So it is, well, while it is an ancient design, I still think it's very beautiful and still practical in a way. Which shows again, look, yes, 1500 years old and it still looks modern. And it strikes me often that with modern knife designs, when people want to impress too much, want to try to make something which they think is very modern and avant-garde, well, typically that kind of design that they come up with gets old-fashioned and tired very quick. The truly classical designs tend to be very pure and elegant. So I don't use this very often. I used it a few times out of curiosity, but it still works well and it's especially beautiful. So another interesting thing if you're into knives, the Hanwei Scrama Sax, the small model, really was meant for personal carry. I think it's beautiful. So put them again side by side. The big prehistoric knife here in the native Indian version, but really the prehistoric replicas look very much the same, and here the one from the late Roman early medieval era. Well, I hope that you liked my 30th knife review, something out of the ordinary. As usual, feel free to leave bluntly honest feedback.